Welcome to our show of Lecha Dodi at the Jewish Radio, Parashat Shavua, Parashat Reeh. Parashat Shavua, Parashat Reeh speaks about a Navi Sheker. That Navi Sheker is demonstrated in the Torah very specifically and fits the criteria of Jesus exactly. And let's see and read those psukim. With that much explanation, one could really just look into the pasuk and see everything clearly from there. The pasuk says, I'll read it in the lashon of the pasuk, and then we translate it and explain it. Ki yakum bekirbecha navi o cholem chalom venatan elecha ot o mofet uva ot vamofet asher diber elecha lemor nelcha acharei elohim acherim asher lo yedatem vanavdem lo tishma el divrei navi ahu o el cholem chalom ahu ki menase Adonai Elohechem etchem ladat ha'ishchem ohavim et Adonai Elohechem b'chol levavchem u'b'chol nafshechem. Acharei Adonai Elohechem telechu v'oto tirahu v'et mitzvotav tishmoru v'kolo tishmau v'oto ta'avodu v'ot tidbakun. V'anaviru o'cholem ha'chalom ahu yumat ki diber sara al Adonai Elohechem u'mutzi etchem eretz mitzrayim v'apodecha mibet avadim la'adichacha min haderech asher tzivecha Adonai Elohecha lelechet ba uvi'ar ta'ara mikirbecha. The Torah over here says the following. Ki yakum bekirbecha navi. If there should stand upon you, upon Am Yisrael, in the midst of Am Yisrael, a prophet, or cholem chalom, or a dreamer, natan elecha ot o mofet, and he will bring about a sign or a wonder. Uva ot v'amofet asher diber elecha. And this dream or wonder will come about, and he will say to you the following. Once he got you, he trapped you with the miracle that he made. Now that you believe in him, he will tell you the following: Nelcha acharei Elohim acharim. Let's follow different gods. Asher lo yedatem v'na'avdem. Different gods that you didn't know, you don't recognize, and we should worship that God. So here we go. We have over here a prophet that tells us exactly things that's going to happen, and is able to bring about the miracle. And he does those miracles openly. For instance, as Jesus did, walks on the water. He heals those that are dying, those that are sick, those that has a tzaraat, leprosy, heals them, or he revives the dead. A wonderful thing. You see such a person, it captures your heart. Natan elechaot u'mufet, v'uva'ot v'amufet. The miracle comes about. He's able to do it. The Torah over here says, don't doubt it. He can do miracles. There's such a thing. Sometimes a Kadosh Baruch Hu would give powers to a person to do miracles, to capture the people, and he's a false prophet. The Torah says about it, lo tishma el divrei hanavi ahu. Don't listen to him. O el cholem ha'chalom ahu. Ki menaseh. What's the purpose of a Kadosh Baruch Hu doing such a thing? You might wonder, why does a Kadosh Baruch Hu give power to that person to do miracles and then comes to get people to go after him, do the wrong thing, worship different gods? Why would a Kadosh Baruch Hu give such a person such powers? Torah says, you know why? Ki menaseh Hashem Elokechem etchem. Ladat ha'ishchem ohavim et Hashem Elokechem b'chol levavchem u'b'chol nafshechem. Hashem is testing you. That's what it is. Torah says openly, Hashem is testing you with that. What's the test? Let's see if you really love HaKadosh Baruch Hu. If you love HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you're not going to be manipulated by this person. And therefore, the Torah here explicitly, openly tells us there should be such a person. And he would do miracle. He would revive the dead. He would heal the blind. He would walk on water. He would do other miracles, a list of miracles. One could say that it's not true. It is true. That's not our discussion today. Even if it would be true, even everything that they say about him would be true, Torah says over here, 1 minute, did he tell you to go and worship other gods? He did. There's something called Trinity. There's something called worshiping Jesus. There's something called worshiping differently than the Torah said and allowed, worshiping HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Oops. That doesn't fit the condition over here. Va'od v'amufet asher dibercha lemor nelcha acharei Elohim acherim. Go and worship other gods asher lo yedatam v'na'avdem. different gods that you didn't know. Let's worship them. You know that person is a false prophet. You know he's a fraud. You know this person doesn't belong in Am Hashem. Therefore, what should we do to that person? Torah says, "Acharei shoyim elokechem telechu." You should follow only HaKadosh Baruch Hu, not him. V'oto tirao. You should fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu, not him. V'et mitzvotav tishmoru. You should follow the laws of HaKadosh Baruch Hu and not what this person tells you. If he tells you there's, you don't have to keep the laws anymore, a New Testament, everything is new now, HaKadosh Baruch Hu abandoned the Jews, all kind of new stories, all kind of interesting things, all kind of spiritual ideas. Torah says, no, no, no. You should follow HaKadosh Baruch Hu, fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu, follow His mitzvot. Uvekolot tishmau, listen only and follow the orders of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. V'oto ta'avodu, you should worship only HaKadosh Baruch Hu. V'ot idbakun, you should be attached to the Makor Chaim HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So what do we do with that prophet? Says the Torah, V'anavi ahu, o cholem ha'chalom ahu, that prophet, or the dreamer, yumat, should be killed. Ki diber sara al Adonai Elohim ha'motzi etchem eretz Mitzrayim, because he spoke negatively about HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that took you out of Mitzrayim, v'apodecha mibet avicha, le'adichacha min haderech, in order to make you mistaken over other things. Here we go. Torah explicitly speaks about such a prophet that will come about and do such things and try to manipulate you to go and follow other gods or follow other ideas. And Torah says, don't listen to it. The next psukim speak about the same idea, a little bit different. Ki yesitcha achicha ben imecha ovincha ovitcha ashet achikecha orecha asher kenafshecha baseter lemor nilcha venavda Elohim achirim asher lo yadata ata avavotecha. Should be, sometimes one person, even from your family, that would try to deceive you to go and follow other gods. And when he does that, you should know that such person has to be killed. How do you kill such a person? Says the Torah, Ki arok ta'argenu. You should kill him. Yadecha tiyeh bo b'rishona le'amito v'yad kolam b'achorona. How is the death? What is the death for such a person that's called emasit u'madiach, which means a person that tries to get you away from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, tries to tell you to worship other gods? Uskalto ba'avanim v'amet. You should stone him to death. Because he tried to get you away from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And that should be done in public. You know why? Chol Yisrael ishmeu v'irau v'lo yosifu la'asot kedavar hara hazeh bekirbecha. So over here, we learn that such a person that tries to tell you, come, follow me, let's worship other gods, such a person should be stoned to death. What do you do with a person that's being stoned? The Torah says later on, in Parashat Ki Tetzeh, V'chi yeh be'ish chet mishpat mavet v'humat v'talita oto aletz. What does that mean? Rashi says over here, and this is the way it says in the Gemara, that kol haniskalim nitlin. Every person that received the death by stoning, skila, should be hung. She'ne'emar ki kelalat Elohim taluy. And therefore, over here, the Torah says, "V'chiyeh b'ishchet mishpat mavet." If a person will be stoned to death, that's the understanding in the pasuk. V'humat, he should die. V'talit oto aletz. Afterwards, he should be hung on the tree. Interesting that the pasuk over here of yesitcha achicha, that if should be somebody from your brothers, from your family, from your nation, that would try to do to get you away from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, such a thing is death by stoning. What do you do for a person that dies by stoning? You hang him, or you hang him also. Very interesting. Same thing was done to Jesus. He was violating everything that it says over here in the Psukim. He showed himself to be a false prophet, as the Torah says. And the reason he was a false prophet, although he did beautiful, unbelievable miracles, whether yes, whether no, I don't know. But that's what they claim. But even if we take their claim, it says over here in the Torah, and those miracles will come about, Torah says don't believe and don't follow him, and you should kill him. And if he tries to get you away from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you should stone him to death as well. And what do you do after you stone him to death? Hang him. Why is that? Because the Torah says, "Chol Yisrael yishmeu v'yirahu." Everybody has to see it. It has to be visible. Everybody has to see this thing. That's one of the fourth mitzvot that everybody has to see, because yishmeu kol am yishmeu v'yirahu. Everybody has to see and be warned not to do such a mistake ever again. Very interesting what's going on over here. The Gemara even goes and tells us a description of what happened with Jesus. And the Torah says that he was hung on Erev Pesach. And how was he hung? Was it the Romans? No, no. The Torah doesn't say that. Our Torah, the Gemara says, Sanhedrin killed him. Why did the Sanhedrin kill him? The Sanhedrin killed him because the Torah says so. Open in the Bible. How could you change? How could you go and argue with the Bible? Torah says, when a person does such thing, uskal tova met. So therefore, says the Gemara, that was what was done to Jesus. Jesus is called over here in the Gemara, Ben Sitda. And we soon see why was the Gemara calling him Ben Sitda, which means the son of Sitda. In the end of the Gemara, after the whole discussion, the Gemara would come out saying that Sitda means a woman that was mistaken from her husband. She went with a different man. She did the wrong thing. And therefore, that's called Satat Da Mi Ba'ala. She was a Sota, like the Torah is talking about. Isha Sota, which means she goes with another man, and such adultery will be Davar Ha'asur. So that's what she did over here, and that's why her son is called Ben Sitda. But right now, in the discussion of the Gemara starts by not knowing, so to speak, what does it mean, Sitda? It seems like it's a name. So the Gemara in Sanhedrin Samech Zayin, not always it's printed because of the fear of the censor. So in the old prints and the new prints, they already brought it about. So it says, V'chen asu leben Sitda belod, she'esit la'avodah zarah. He was bringing people to worship Avodah Zarah. And therefore, they hung him also on Erev Pesach. Talu be'erev Pesach, they hung him. Why did they hang him? Where do we find in the Torah such a death by hanging? There's no such thing. Rather, they didn't hang him alive, they killed him first, like the Gemara says. Some want to say that they did it not that way, and there are reasons that brought down in the poskim why he was hung alive. But whether he was alive, or just like the Torah says, that first he should be stoned and then hung, whatever it is, they afterwards hang him. When was that done? When was this story happened? Erev Pesach. Just like the old story of the New Testament. Maksha Gemara on that. The Gemara asks on this, his name is Ben Sada? Ben Pandira. His name is not Ben Sada. His name is Ben Pandira. Why is it that you're calling him Ben Sada? Amar Rav Chisna, Baal Satda Boel Pandira. The husband of Miriam, that was Mezaneh, that was the mother of Jesus, her husband's name is Satda. But the person that was with Miriam, that's the Boel, his name is Pandira. Says the Gemara, really? The name of the husband is Satda? That's not true. Baal Papus Ben Yehuda, his name is Papus Ben Yehuda, not Satda. Rather, the Gemara says, Ela Ima Imo Satda. His mother is Satda, not his father. Says the Gemara, his mother is Satda. His mother is also not Satda. His mother is called Miriam Egal Lanash. She was Miriam, and she used to fix the hair of the ladies. Rather, the reason she was called Satda, says the Gemara, Satda Da Mibala. She was Sote. She moved away from the right way by doing the wrong thing with a different man, and by that, having Jesus born. So therefore, the Gemara over here says clearly the story of what happened, what's the name of the father, what's the name of the mother, what was the nickname, the name of the father was Miriam, what's her job, she was fixing the hair, she was braiding the hair of the ladies. The Gemara in Chagigah Daf Dalet speaks about this as well. And the Gemara over there, Tosfot over there, says that this was the mother of Yeshu. And the Gemara says over here what's the name of the husband and what's the name of the boel as well. So we have the whole history, and the Gemara tells us exactly what happened as well. It's not the only Gemara. There's other Gemarot also that tell us who were the students of Jesus as well and what happened to them as well. There's other Gemarot by Sota that tell us that how was Jesus mistaken. How did he make that mistake? That he started following the wrong route. Slowly. He was one of the Talmidei Chachamim. He used to be a regular Jew learning Torah. But in the end, he was mistaken. He followed the wrong way. And on that, the Rambam says the following in the end of Hilchot Melachim. Ve'af oto shedama shiye Mashiach, this person that thought, or he made himself to be a Mashiach, ve'ne'erak bebetin, kvar nitnaba bo Daniel. Rambam, first of all, openly says, don't think the Romans killed him. He died in Beit Din. And the Daniel HaNavi, the prophet Daniel, prophesies about him. And he said, Uvnei pritzei amecha inasu la'amit chazon v'nichshalu. Pritzei amecha, those that from the lowest of the nation, that would be poretz, that would open up any other fence of security of the Torah, would break that fence and go out. Bnei pritzei amecha inasu, they would be picked up, they would be rising all of a sudden. People would follow them, they would get a name. Le'amit chazon v'nichshalu. Nevertheless, it's a stumble block. They would fall down. It's not going to do good, not for them, not for the people. V'chi yesh michshol gadol mizeh, says the Rambam. Do you have a bigger stumble than this? Shekol ha-Nevi'im dibu sha-Mashiach goel le-Israel. All the Nevi'im said, Mashiach would redeem Am Yisrael. Would bring the Geulah to Am Yisrael. That's the purpose of Mashiach. U'mekabetz nitcheem u'mechazek ha-mitzvot. Mashiach's purpose is to get people stronger in mitzvot. To get people stronger and tighter with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Would be mekabetz nidachim. Would bring and gather all Am Yisrael to one place. V'ze גם לאבד ישראל בחרב ולפזר שריתם, להשפילם, להחליף התורה, להטות רוב העולם, לעבוד מבלדי השם. Jesus did just the opposite. What did he do? He destroyed Am Israel, him and his followers. Whether it was with a sword, whether it was, he scattered Am Israel throughout the whole world. He put them down. He changed the Torah instead of being mechazek the Torah. He changed the Torah. He says, don't follow the Torah. Torah was changed. And he mistaken most of the world. That's the words of the Rambam. Rambam, as you all know already, we spoke about this in the past, holds that Christianity is Avodah Zarah. And so does other poskim as well. Christianity is Avodah Zarah. Christianity is Avodah Zarah because they worship Jesus. They worship and bow down to different idols. They have idols either in the house or in their place of worship. They bow down to them. They have the cross, they bow down to it. That's Avodah Zarah. Not only Avodah Zarah, we spoke already in the past. It also has to do with Minut, because they believe in something that the Torah says it's not true, which means the Kadosh Baruch Hu is only one, and they're saying there's three. They believe that the Torah is changed. That's Apikorsut. My Apikoros. Who is Apikoros? The Gemara says, whoever puts down Talmidei Chachamim and says, Mayahanu lanani rabbanan. What does also Talmidei Chachamim help us? They don't help us in any way. And they don't know, says the Gemara, that the whole world stands on this Talmidei Chachamim. And the reason the whole world stands on this Talmidei Chachamim is because they learn the Torah Kedoshah, and the Torah Kedoshah revives the world. That's the oxygen of the world. HaKadosh Baruch Hu doesn't need this world if there's no oxygen, and that's the Torah. Im lo briti, yomam v'layla, chukot shamayim v'aretz lo samti. Brit is the brit Torah. If you don't have the brit of the Torah, Kadosh Baruch Hu doesn't need the world at all. So the message over here is that this very person called Jesus was Oved Avodah Zarah. He was a Masit u'Madiach that was killed according to the way the Torah says, which Sekila, and he was also hung. But one need to know that there is a machloket in the Gemara, in the Poskim, if Ben Sitta is really Yeshu. According to the Yerushalmi, Yerushalmi says that Yeshu is called Pandira, which fits a little bit the Gemara over here. Tosfot says that, Tosfot in Chagigat Daf Dalet, we mentioned before, we said that Miriam Megadla Nasha, that's the mother of Yeshu. And this is how the Yad Rama brings down that, and this is how Tosfot Chachmei Anglia say. But there are those that say that it's not. Tosfot in Shabbat, Kuf Daled, seems to say that there were two Yeshu, because it couldn't be this Yeshu, because Babus ben Yehuda, that we're talking about over here, that was the husband of the mother of Yeshu, he was in the time of Rabbi Akiva. And Rabbi Akiva was way before Rabbi Yeshua ben Prachya. Now, I mentioned already before that in Sotam Mem Zayin, there was a story with Jesus and his Rebbe, Rabbi Yeshua ben Prachya, that Rabbi Yeshua ben Prachya took him out. He was menadeh. He puts him out of Klal Yisrael by Jesus doing something wrong. And then when he decided that he might be time already to bring him back, it was too late already. He was mistaken and he went away. The Gemara deals with that over there. But that story is way after Rabbi Akiva. And way before Rabbi Akiva. And therefore, this can't be the same Yeshu as the Gemara over there in the Gemara Shabbat Kuf Daled. Therefore, it seems like there's two different Yeshu. And this is how many of the poskim say. But however it is, however we're going to learn this Yeshu, the Torah, what it says in the Pasuk, in the Psukim, in our parasha, Parashat Re'eh, speaks clearly of such a person that will come and do whatever Yeshu did. And the Torah clearly says that such a person should not be believed and should not be followed. This parasha over here takes the carpet under the table. It takes the base from the whole Christian religion. With that, those psukim that they themselves have in their Bible, it completely rips the whole religion about. And therefore, this is a very big chizuk for one that needs to know that the reason the Torah says not to follow such a thing is because Hashem was testing the people to see if they really love Him. Or a person gets excited from seeing a little bit miracles. And once a person sees miracle, he's blinded already. Forgets what it says in the Torah. But we need to know that the Jews never followed, because they knew the Torah Kedoshah says, don't follow such a person. And throughout history, he's not the only one. They happened again and again that false messiahs came about and false prophets. And we had stories over stories. But the Torah tells us exactly who you should follow and who not. And therefore, Am Yisrael was never stumbled by that.